Snuggle and watch some more. I got to smell his garlic breath. It was great! I savored it! I wrote this after listening to Visions of Johanna. I didn't really steal a line, but I kind of borrowed one, almost. I used the word electricity in the same word as hallway, and he, you know, in the same sentence. And he did that in one of his sentences, and I always felt a little guilty for it. The context is different, I swear, you know, but I was opening for him and I got embarrassed about singing it. I was like, what if he hears it and he, like, thinks you stole it? He did. Yeah, and he calls me down to his dressing room and I'm like, so I get down there and he's like, what was that one song you were singing that sometimes it, sorry, sorry song? And I was like, sometimes it be that way? And he goes, yeah, and I'm like, he's like, what are the words to that? I'm like, what? I write no words, ye of almighty word master. Anyway, this is the song. Night with its shattered teeth, attempt to speak my pen's presence, but courage left via the sink, and I'm sorry I snuck up on you from behind. Sorry not all my love letters did rhyme, and I'm sorry that Jesus died for my sins, and I swear to God, and I'm sorry if it was my swerve that tempted you to sway. Chases its tail in the hall, and I'm sorry my arms to you are just empty John. Behind those dead drums, percussion.
Thank you.
Time, man. He's calling him stupid. Everybody stared and listened really hard for mistakes. I really can't tell you how pleasing it is to be here and have this many people show up to see me.
Keep seeping out like cheap gin.
isn't too country. I suck at country guitar riffs, but that's alright. There's a picture of John Maynard. Oh. You guys see John Maynard? He just started film. Hot! Oh, hello there. Thank you. I really appreciate that. She's my manager. She helps protect my little spirit in the shark world. So everybody thank Inga. This is her favorite song.
The doorway frames you a picture perfect silhouette. Blue sky of regret, enough to hang ya. Your legs seem to tremble, at least I imagine that. Then again, it's probably easy for you.
together. It's called Silver Lining.
Something like you.
yellow street lamps, like the night, lonely street corners, sobbing cry, car is silent, I can hear my thoughts, the belly is full.
California, my car broke down, and I was like, well, do I hitchhike to a gas station? I was like, I saw that movie, California. What did you think about hitchhiking? So I was like, okay, angels, I want a nice ride. So I sat there and wait. The guy pulls over finally, you know, and he goes, before you get in, you have to promise me one thing. All right. The next time you see somebody that needs help, you have to help them. He's spiritual. Okay, so I get in the car, and he's very nice. We're talking about the weather and bad haircuts and things like that. On the way back, we're driving, you know, down the 6-lane freeway. He's taking me back to my car, and he says out of the blue, don't you think men are the primordial scum of the planet Earth? And I went, no, I don't, bad girls. Men are not the primordial scum of the planet Earth. They're nice. So I was like, no, and the guy's like, no, I mean, really, don't you think men are just self-serving? And I went, no. And he goes, I mean, really, don't you think men are just pigs? And I went, are you about to be one? Because, I mean, Jesus Christ, just look at you. Would you show me your tits? How can I approach a girl so that she'll do this for me? What? What? Oh my God. So I wrote this song for him. It's called My Own Private God's Gift to Women.
Would you like to ram your tongue down my throat? Would you like to grab my
wasn't it? I feel like we're on the Price is Right. Losing your hair. He's like, yeah, thanks. I know that. it's also how they came up with like these sayings like harebrained ideas, split hair decision. And I realize it's like senility, your brain grows out. It's like gone. It starts getting sloppy in there, grows out your eyebrows. So my dad, he yodels and he had these eyebrows up for this phase. He thought chicks dug it. They're looking at you the way they look at 80-year-old men that are dripping Gerber, like, how cute. I love my dad, I just give him a hard time. So he comes up and he yodels, he wags his head, he's like, yodel. It's kind of funny, but he can't do it unless he gets wobbling like a washing machine not killed through his head. And so with his eyebrows, he looked like these windshield wipers. He's like, and I think of that every time I yodel and it makes me laugh, and now I want you to share that little memory with me. My father's long memory is wrong. Absolutely ridiculous. apartments, my stock and my kill. Got social security, got dumb bills. There's addictions to feed, there's amounts to pay. So bother with the devil, but you won't get born today. Say, hey, mom, I'm taking money in Rome. Take my hands while I'm sweet on, but it was one of those things. Don't play it, let's make it. Got a concert out on the streets, girl. Close your eyes, move inside me. There you are. To where we become what we're told as children. We're very vulnerable to our surroundings. And a lot of us are surrounded by a lot of concrete, which isn't necessarily bad, but if you're also surrounded by teachers that are uninspiring and parents that are unencouraging, if not damaging, and then religion on top of it telling you that you're dirty by mere existence, you can, you know, it's no wonder that kids feel a little bit of angsty. It's like all these politicians going, I wonder why they were so upset. We should be told we're good from birth. I think we are by nature good. You know, I think we are designed by nature. And if we are never taught to understand ourselves, we're never given tools to understand our emotions. We have to go to therapists to be understood and to God to be forgiven. No wonder. And writing for me has really helped me get in touch with my own process, my own emotions, and my own feelings. It's kind of been my little therapist. It makes me intimate with myself. So I really want some fresh feelings. And I think that, you know, because we're given no real tools to understand ourselves, it's no wonder most of us turn to drugs, you know, to feel relaxed or to feel good about ourselves or to watch television or sex, to distract ourselves. And there are other ways to do it, and I do encourage you, because I do think all those things are pretty much distractions. Yeah. of a great bedtime.